All right, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and jump into this install. I'm gonna give you a rundown of what I'm gonna be doing. Pretty much, this is gonna be on the driver's side. This is the speaker grill area. I'm gonna be removing the trim that comes from the top left corner. I'm gonna be replacing it with this Cartrimhome unit. It has wires here, so I do need to feed this through the speaker underneath, and then it's gonna come through the driver's side steering wheel area. There are two screws, one located here and the other located on this side, that I'm gonna have to remove, and then it's gonna expose the center area where the wire is gonna be on the bottom here, and it's pretty much gonna be a plug and play after that. So let's go ahead and start taking out the speaker area so that I can access the wire area. There should be clips on each side here. Carefully pry it. The next part is gonna be a 10 millimeter bolt on both sides. I've already removed this in the past when I installed my OEM audio plus tweeters. And here you go, the speaker is exposed. All right, so I'm feeling this area to see where I can run the wire through. The next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a clothes hanger and I'm just gonna hook it all the way through. You can either go through the A pillar or you can go through the hole that it has behind the speaker. So I'm gonna go through this area. What I'm gonna do now is to attach the line to the clothes hanger. I'm gonna use some tape to tape it up so that it's gonna feed through. I'm gonna go ahead and feed this line until it gets all the way through. As I fed it through, I'm gonna go ahead and remove the clothesline now. Now that the wire is fed, I'm just gonna go ahead and install the speaker back in. Fully pull from the bottom, and then I'm gonna go ahead and snap it in. Gonna have to turn on the car. Access one side. Let's go ahead and remove this. Access the other side. Now with the trim tools, I'm gonna go ahead and wedge this between the top and the bottom section, and it should pry open. I'm not gonna take that whole unit out. I'm just gonna take out the bottom since that's where I need access. Okay, that part's off. Okay, next part of the install, this is underneath the dash. I'm gonna be using both the harnesses that were included here. I'm gonna start by connecting these two together. I'm actually gonna be taping this up so that it's more secure. Okay, now the next part of this install, I'm actually going to be removing this blue clip right here. So make sure the vehicle is off. There you go, the blue clip is off. I'm gonna go ahead and plug this male to this female. And then I'm gonna stick this male back into where the blue plug went. There you go. Now the last thing I'm gonna do here is grab the wire that I just fished. I'm gonna fish it underneath here so it's nice and clean. And at this point, it just connects to this last open. There you go. Use the zip ties that were included. Now let's go ahead and put the covers back on. Okay, now that both top and bottom are back in, I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the vehicle so I can access the screw area, reassemble it back. All right, the next part of the install, I'm gonna use some alcohol and clean this area before I put on the film. It does come with two of these in case you mess up. I hope I get it done right the first time around. It first wants me to peel off one side so I can apply it on, and then I'll peel off the other side before I squeegee it down. So I kind of see where it's gonna be at. Okay. I'm gonna sit my position, make sure that I can see the display. Everything looks pretty good. I need to straighten it out just a tad bit. Looks very solid to me. This is the squeegee that it came with. Go ahead and squeegee out any of the bubbles. So far, so good. Now I'm gonna go ahead and remove this last area or this last film. Let me squeegee it one more time. There you go, it looks pretty good to me. I think you guys are gonna get a better view when it gets dark, so I'll go ahead and resume the video during the night. All right, guys, welcome back to the video. It is nighttime, and this is pretty much how the head-up display looks like. I've driven around for a couple of days now. I got a chance to try out some of the features. I like it so far. It looks like it might be distracting on your end, but it works pretty well. It's actually quite see-through, so I can see cars that are coming. That actually doesn't distract me at all. So far, I've played with some of the settings there. As you can see, there's the RPM. There's actually tire sensors. Obviously, there is kilometers per hour, miles per hour as an option. There's also any engine failure lights, like check engine. I think there's some low battery indicator, voltage meter, and doors. I haven't checked the hatch, so I'm gonna see if that hatch sensor will turn on when I open the back. But so far, so good. As you can see, there's a blinker for the lane change. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I really love it so far. I think it's a cool feature. I wish all the 4Runners came with this to begin with. I'll go ahead and drop a link below in case you guys are interested. It's really, really cool. Everybody that's been in my car so far has been really impressed with this. I'll catch you guys later. Let me know what you guys think. Peace out, guys.